matrix is symmetric, yes? And we can consider this matrix as a matrix with entries not in, for example, rational numbers, but with entries in the field of two elements. Yes,
ну вот у меня очень плохое видео, в смысле я качество видео очень плохое. То есть я вижу, но ничего не вижу.
Now non-degeneracy of the graph J, G is one if A G is non-degenerate and zero otherwise. So we just compute the determinant of A G, but not in the field of rational numbers, in the field of in F2, yes, and if we get zero, then the graph is degenerate, otherwise it is non-degenerate.
Ой, сейчас гораздо лучше.
So, for example, if the number of vertices in G is odd, then G is degenerate. Is it clear? Who knows why? Why is it true? Why is why if V of J yes, yes. So if we have an this is not exactly the same, but we know that there are no loops in our graph, so this is exactly the same thing. Yes. Yes. Now we define, we are ready to define a Skew characteristic polynomial for non-oriented graph. And we define it as follows. Is this polynomial where the coefficient uk is the following sum? Is the following sum? We take subset of the set of vertices and take the non-degeneracy of the graph induced by vertices in I. Yeah. I consists of two elements. Okay. Yes, so for example, what is the degree of this polynomial? Okay. Of course, the degree is equal to the number of vertices in G because we may put K equal zero here. Yes. And we get zero, which is of course one, which is very like abstract thing, but yes. For example, if we take two graphs, J1 and J2, and we take their product, I will recall that their product is just a disjoint union of this graph. And then what is the two characteristic polynomial of their product? Yes, because of course non-degeneracy of disjoint union is just the product of non-degeneracy of corresponding graphs. Okay. What more? Okay. For example, if J consists of one vertex, what is U of J? Oh, G. If G consists of one vertex, what is Q of G? This is just U. Now I will recall that we that the space of graphs has a Hopf algebra structure. Okay, maybe I will not prove it now, but I will explain why this is called. Because it may seem like these two definitions are not related in any way, but in fact, for some graphs, we may choose an orientation in such way that these two definitions coincide. So we had the first definition for oriented graph and the second definition for non-oriented graph. If our graph is an intersection graph of some chord diagram, then we can choose an orientation on this graph, and these two definitions will give the same answer. Okay, so the space of all graphs is graded by the number of vertices. The multiplication of, I said, the product of two graphs is just their disjoint union. Multiplication. Or co-multiplication of G is sum over this coefficient. So we discussed it already earlier. And I will recall that if you have a Hopf algebra, then some of its elements are said to be primitive. What it means? P is primitive if co-multiplication of P is 1 tensor P plus P tensor 1. Co-product, yes. Thank you. for product of this element is this thing. And there is a theorem, Milner-Moore theorem. Yeah. Yes, there is a Milner-Moore theorem which states that this Hopf algebra of graphs is it's not about in fact Milner-Moore theorem is not about exactly this Hopf algebra. It is about any co-commutative Hopf algebra, but it states that this Hopf algebra is generated as an algebra by all primitive elements. So this is every element is a polynomial in primitive elements. Yes. So the most basic like case of the theorem when J, when we have Lie algebra and we take its universal enveloping algebra, Okay, but in fact we have we have exact equation for this Hopf algebra. G equals sum over I. I will explain what it means. Okay. So what does it mean this formula? Да, тут надо красивым каким-то писать шрифтом. Ага. Ну вот, вот здесь вот хочется подвинуть буквами, а я вот не знаю, как их красиво написать. Ну давайте как-нибудь, давайте гамму будем. Да. Да, тогда надо еще. Окей. So what does this mean? What is I? I is a partition of the set of vertices. So each each iota j is a subset of vertices in j. So maybe I should modify. What is phi? So phi is a projection from the Hopf algebra j to the set of its primitive elements. Yes. And if we take this product and some overall partitions, we get G itself. So this is a demonstration of this fact. Because this is a polynomial in primitive elements. Thank you. По устам надо?
Нет, просто меня не слышно, а вас слышно.
Ну мы пример просто приводим, как вычислить и от G для конкретного графа, состоящего из двух вершин одного и равных линий.
The graph consisting of a single vertice and a single vertice is projection to the size of the step. So that the graph G can be represented as Q of G plus P of Parton square.
Да, то есть вот мы явно представили наш граф в виде многочлена от примитивных элементов, которые на самом деле являются подграфами. Окей. Why we are interested in primitive elements? Because we have a theorem about the values of two characteristic polynomial on primitive elements. And the theorem states that if G contains at least two vertices, then the value of skew characteristic polynomial on the projection is constant. So it will, it is not a polynomial, it's a polynomial of degree zero. And what is the value of skew characteristic polynomial on pi of j? Pi of j is not a graph. Pi of j is linear combination of graphs, but of course we can define skew characteristic polynomial for any element in Hopf algebra J just by linearity. Yep. Да, давайте. Да, давайте вот продемонстрируем на том, что мы уже посчитали. Да, вот у нас есть граф. Окей. We have a graph G. And we want to show that Q pi of G is constant. What is Q pi of G? Q pi of G is Q of this graph minus Q of this graph. What is Q of this graph? Of this is easier, the second term, because this is just a product of one point graph, which we have already computed. This square. And what is this? So this is, I think, yes, what is the quadratic? So we get one. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's prove. Let's prove this theorem. So we use this expression, yes, but I will rewrite it in slightly different way. G equals phi of G plus all the other terms. 1 over phi not equal to the set of all vertices. And now I want to prove by induction on the number of vertices in G. Okay. So what if I take the skew characteristic polynomial on the left? I will get just Q of G. And what I will get on the right? U pi of G plus oh, maybe this is not good. Видно еще что-нибудь, когда я тут пишу? Okay, we have this formula. And now, what is this skew characteristic polynomial? We already know that so this graph restricted to the vertices of Yota. It has a smaller number of vertices. So by induction assumption, this skew characteristic polynomial is constant, or this graph contains exactly one vertex. Yes? So, okay, let us compute the coefficient of u to the power k on the left and on the right. Here is the coefficient of u to the power k. We denote it maybe not u to the power k, maybe u to the power. Let us compute the coefficient of this term on both sides. Yes. So on the left side, we denote this coefficient QK. On the right side, we have the coefficient of skew characteristic polynomial, which we don't know, but here, yeah, to get the power, to get this power, we must have. Okay, let me denote this by n. Much simpler. So to get u to the power n minus k, we need to have exactly n minus k parts of in I consisting of one element of one vertex, because here any skew characteristic polynomial is either constant, either u. If G, if G restricted to iota consists of one vertex, then the corresponding two characteristic polynomial is U. We have computed already. So what do we get? We need to choose some vertices which let us remove all the parts which consists of one vertices, and we get this thing of one vertex. Some over partition. Мне тоже нравится, не видно. Yes. But now, what is written here? Here we take all partitions of U and then this part. And this is the same. We used once again this formula, but not for G. We use it for G restricted to U. Okay. Clear? Yes, we need to pick free term here. But free term of this polynomial is, of course, non-degeneracy of J restricted to U. So just the definition of two characteristic polynomial. Yes? Yes, we get this, and this is exactly the coefficient QK. So we get this is zero. Yes. And in fact, there is a nice way to compute this constant. So we know that U pi of j of g is constant, but which constant? And in fact, there is a nice way to compute this constant when g is an intersection graph of chord diagram. But maybe I won't tell you in detail. Now we have defined a Skew characteristic polynomial for oriented graphs and for non-oriented graphs. Let us now define the Skew characteristic polynomial for the chord diagram C. Let's see the chord diagram. And we want to define its Skew characteristic polynomial. Each chord diagram has its intersection graph G of C. Okay, so the vertices of this graph are chords, and we join two vertices if and only if the corresponding chords intersect. Now we want to choose an orientation on this graph, orientate the edges. Let us draw the chord diagram. Example like this. And a chord diagram, I will recall that chord diagram is not only the circle with chords, it is the circle given with an orientation. Okay. So now we mark some point which is not the end of any chord. And we cut the circle at this point. We get a line and a number. Now we draw these chords on the plane 1, 6, 2, 8, 3, 5, and 4, 7. And we want to choose an orientation of some edge in the intersection graph. So for example, take the edge 1, 6, take the chord 1, 6, and the chord, I know, 4, 7, for example. Okay. So the orientation of this edge, so this edge goes from the chord with smaller left number of left ends to the chord with greater number of left ends. So we order the edges according to the order of left ends of the corresponding chords. 1. Here's the left end is 1. Here's the left end is 4. 4 is greater than 1, so we have h like this. Yes. Two, 8, 2, 5. What edges do we have? 2, 8, and 1, 6. 3, 5, and 4, 7. So we get 4, 7, 1, 6. So we get this oriented graph. And of course, this graph depends on on the choice of mark point, cut point, the orientation depends on this point. And we can, so we will denote this graph by J of T with an arrow. And we define two characteristic polynomial of this chord diagram as the characteristic, two characteristic polynomial of the corresponding graph G of C. But we do not know that this definition is correct. We do not know that this definition is independent from the choice of the cut point. Yes, we need to check it. Okay, let's check. Maybe so what happens when we move? Yeah, yeah. Two characteristic polynomial of the chord diagram does not depend on the choice. Of the cut point. Yeah, so what happens if we move this cut point from this arc to the neighboring one? This. What happens? All chords remain the same, except the only one, 1/6. Yes? If we move the cut point here, then 1/6 now, the one now is here. One goes to the end. And we draw this chord. So, arc, yes. So, which orientation we must switch? Orientations. For example, if the first graph had adjacency matrix A, yes, then up to renumbering of arcs, A prime is looks like this. We need to change orientation of all edges which are incident to the vertex 1/6. Yes. So here 1/6 and 2/8 intersect, and we draw. To 8, and we draw the edge from 1/6 to 8. But now this is the left end of 1/6, and the left end of 2/8 is smaller. Yes. So now after this move, we need to draw the edge in the opposite direction. Okay. And all other edges remain the same. No, on this, yes, in this picture, of course, we need to change all edges which are incident to 1/6. And up to numbering of vertices, this is exactly this operation. We switch the signs of all entries in the first row and in the first column. But of course, the characteristic polynomial of this matrix and this matrix are the same. So this was the proof. Okay. Yes, now we just want to show that so we have defined a Skew characteristic polynomial of chord diagram using the oriented graphs. But we also could define it just like we also could say that Skew characteristic polynomial of a chord diagram is a Skew characteristic polynomial of its intersection graph, G of C. Yes, this is a non-oriented graph, but we have defined Skew characteristic polynomial for non-oriented graphs. So we may check that these two definitions coincide. I will not give the complete proof, but the proof relies on the following proposition that the three term of QC, where QC is defined in this place. C is a chord diagram. The free term of QC coincides with non-degeneracy of intersection graph of C. Okay. So essentially this theorem states the following. So characteristic polynomial of corresponding not characteristic polynomial, but if we say just determinant, because free term is determinant of determinant of this matrix is either zero or one, and it is zero if the corresponding ribbon graph, it is one if the corresponding ribbon graph has a connected boundary. Yes. Mm-hmm. Нет, когда я пишу со стрелочкой, это значит ориентация, это ориентация. А если без стрелочки, это просто не ориентирован, просто intersection graph. Yeah. So this is not the proof. This is just what does this proposition means. So this determinant is either zero or one, depending on whether the bandwidth corresponding Lieben graph is connected. And the connectedness of the boundary is exactly the same thing as a non-degeneracy of intersection graph. And the corollary of this proposition is that defined characteristic polynomial of a chord diagram corresponds coincide with characteristic polynomial of its intersection graph. So we have defined this polynomial using oriented graphs. Yes. But we might consider just its orientation graph and take this polynomial intersection graph, yes. So in particular, we see that two characteristic polynomial does not depend on a chord diagram itself, but only on its intersection graph. Yes, so if two chord diagrams have the same intersection graph, then their stochastic polynomials will be the same. Okay, so how can we prove this statement? We may just note that what is this polynomial? This polynomial is a characteristic polynomial of adjacency matrix. Yes. What is the coefficient of u to the power k here? This is the sum of principal minors. Yes. Of principal k minors. This is the coefficient n minus k minors. But what is n minus k minor? So if we have some rows and columns, principal minor. What is corresponding determinant? The corresponding determinant is just the non-degeneracy of chord diagram with vertices with these numbers, which we have here. Chords. Chords. So if we want to compute this determinant, this minor, principal minor, we may remove all the other chords from a chord diagram and compute the non-degeneracy of this chord diagram. If it's correspond, but we know that it coincides with non-degeneracy of the corresponding intersection graph, which is this proposition. Yes. So we get that all the coefficients coincide. I don't know, maybe this is not very clear, but any questions? Понятно, нет? Я повторю. Могу просто сказать, потому что это действительно не объясняет. Ну, то есть мы хотим посчитать коэффициент при, допустим, k-й степени этого многочлена. Премин с k-й степени. Что такое коэффициент премин с k-й степени? Это коэффициент характеристического многочлена премин с k-й степени. Это, как мы знаем, сумма всех главных k-миноров, да, в матрице. Взяли какой-то k-минор. Вот оставили какие-то строчки и столбцы с теми же номерами. Эти строчки и столбцы, они соответствуют хордам в хордовой диаграмме, да, потому что в хордовой диаграмме, как бы у нас граф, в нем вершина, это хорды. Вот. Соответственно, мы оставили только эти хорды, все остальные мы выкинули. И, по сути, мы просто написали соответствующий ориентированный граф для хордовой диаграммы вот с выкинутыми хордами. Да? А это по утверждению, вот этот вот определитель, это то же самое, что невырожденность соответствующего графа GC. Да, просто вот это вот использовали это утверждение, но только не для G, а для, в смысле, не для C, а для C с выкинутыми хордами. Вот. Использовали это и получили, что это то же самое, что невырожденность соответствующего подграфа. Вот. Ну, в общем, так.
Окей.
The time is over. We still have 10 minutes. Okay. Then maybe. We'll define four term relations. So we have introduced some invariant graphs. Now we want to check whether this invariant gives us the invariant of knots. And to check this, we need to check that this invariant satisfy four-term relations. What is four-term relation? I will recall. We say that a function f, f is function on chord diagram. In our case, f is two characteristic polynomial. We say that F satisfies four term relations if we have the following equality. So here there are no this is not a point here. This is just an expression equals zero. So there are no other ends on these arcs. Yeah? But there are some other ends on dotted arcs. And we do not change them. Yes. So we won't have to have this property. And if F satisfies this relation, we say that F satisfies quaternary relations. So our goal is to check that Skew characteristic polynomial satisfies this condition. Yes. Для всех хорд, для всех хордовых диаграмм, и вот как бы в каждой хордовой диаграмме мы выбираем как бы две такие хорды, да, и меняем, вот делаем соответствующие как бы moves. Yes, so how to check it? To check this theorem. In fact, we want to define more, we want to state more general proposition. We want to state that two characteristic polynomial satisfies quaternary relations not for chord diagrams but for matrices. What is quaternary relations for matrices? For matrices, it can be written as follows: f of a minus f of a prime minus f of a tilde with f of a prime two. What is written here? What is zero? So A is adjacency matrix of some graph. What is F? F is a function on anti-symmetric matrices with coefficients where I think it doesn't matter. No, in Q, for example, in Q. Not in Q. Yes. Because this is a fact not about like this is a fact just about characteristic polynomials. What I want to say. So if the matrix A looks like this, what makes this operation? A prime, we need just to put these two entries equal zero. all other entries are the same. What field means? Field means that we multiply A from both sides by this matrix. So what happened? We first we take the second row and add it to the first row, and then we take we took second column and add it to the first column. This is exactly what this means. And this is the composition of these two operations. These two operations can be. So this fact, we want just to check that E chi A minus chi A prime minus chi A cube plus chi A cube prime is zero. And this is just the fact about determinants. Yes, we may just write these guys as determinants of the corresponding matrices. And just to check, I do not know why. When you check, I definitely have don't have time.
Okay.
Yeah, I think it is like an exercise. So characteristic polynomial satisfies even more general relations, not only for chord diagram, but I will tell you, maybe I won't tell you the proof, but I will tell you why this relation implies this relation. Yes? Why is it so? So suppose that A is the adjacency matrix of this chord diagram of the corresponding intersection graph. Yes, what happened here? These two chords intersected, now they do not intersect. So yes, these two chords correspond to the vertices 1 and 2. So we had 1 and -1 in matrix A, but A prime, we put these two numbers equal 0. This is now A prime. All other edges are the same, yes? Nothing happens more. But what happened when we made this move? When we made this move, okay, let's consider some chord. So we changed this chord. Now, when the adjacency of this chord and some other chord switch, it switch if and only if this yellow chord intersect second chord in this diagram. So if yellow and pink chords intersect, then this move switch the adjacency of yellow chord and white chord. Yes? Now they do not intersect. If they intersected, if yellow chord do not intersect pink chord, then the adjacency remains the same. Yes, they have intersected and now they are intersecting too. And this is the reason why we add here to matrix A tilde, we add second column, second row to the first row. So maybe we need to return to the question about where lies the entries. Maybe I want to say that they lie in F2, but this fact is true for any entry. But to understand why this relation implies this relation, it will be convenient to think that these entries are in F2, in the group of two elements. Yep. So we add the second row to the first one, and it means exactly that we changed the adjacency of chords which intersect second chord. I don't know if it's better. Если желтая хорда не пересекала розовую, то пересечение, как бы пересекалась ли она с белой хордой, не меняется при вот этом вот этой операции. А если желтая хорда пересекала синюю розовую хорду, то после этой операции у нас поменяется соответствующий, ну, как бы элемент в матрице с нежностью. Да, ну вот картинка. Вот желтая хорда не пересекала розовую, пересекала белую. Тут она снова пересекает белую, вот эту вот. А розовая хорда это вот это.
But I'd like to add a few words. First of all, I'd like to say that this thing is very interesting, so that we are able to work not only over the field of characteristic two, over two, but over a field of arbitrary characteristic, and which means that this p-symmetric matrices have probably more important and wider connection with other combinatorial objects of which we consider invariants. That's one point. The other point is that I'm a bit puzzled with this situation. We know that the skew characteristic value of the skew characteristic polynomial on the projection of a graph to primitives is a constant. Normally, for example, if you take a chromatic polynomial instead of the skew characteristic and take its values on a projection of a graph to the subspace of primitive, it is a linear polynomial, which means that it is a constant times our variable for the chromatic polynomial. And this property corresponds to the fact that the chromatic polynomial is homomorphism of the Hopf algebra structure. My question is how this can be interpreted. Of course, a constant is a very simple thing. Could be multiplied by x, for example, to obtain indeed a homomorphism. But if you multiply the chromatic, the skew characteristic polynomial by x, it fails to be
multiplication. Если мы умножим наш косохарактеристический многочлен на переменную на u, он перестанет быть гомоморфизмом алгебры Хоффа, потому что его значение на несвязанном объединении двух граф перестанет быть произведением его значения на каждом из граф. Maybe we must consider in order to harmonize this situation, we must consider another product. The product should be one vertex connected sum. Sum of graphs, so that if we have such a graph and another one, we should choose a vertex here and connect the vertices so that we obtain a new graph whose number of vertices is one less than the sum of the numbers of vertices of the two parts. But I don't know whether this is indeed a reasonable opinion or not. I don't think that this question is complicated. I believe it is simple, but I would like to have an answer which satisfactory. Well, let's stop here.